was the knight in shining armor in your movie? Well, put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste now. I'm a ghost that called your name.
So I bought a new spray pan yesterday, and I'm about to see how well it works. I'm gonna use it first on my sweet peppers. I have some sweet peppers. They're getting a lot of rainfall, so I'm going to treat them with a little treatment, give them a little more strength because they're kind of weak. So I'm gonna test my new spray to see how well it works. As you can see, I have a lot of water. I don't have a need to bring any water from anywhere because the catchment is full based upon the rainfall. I'm so grateful for that at this moment. So yeah, I'm about to get in the pepper farm now and see how well my new sprayer works. It's pretty small, my size. I kind of like it. It's handy, it's comfortable. So I'm gonna see how well it works. As you can see, you can adjust it here. If you want it to be straight, if you want it to be straight or wide, you can adjust it from here. So I'm gonna stop it until I reach at my pepper farm. So I'm pausing. It's pretty comfortable. Patch now, and they're doing their best now because they have been through a lot, the heavy rain, and it got out of hand with me with the bushes, so I have to get them clean out the other day. Not at perfection, but they're doing pretty fine now. And with this treatment I'm giving to them, it's gonna uplift them and push them to their full potential. These are not normally the way sweet peppers should look, but as I said before, the rain is on them a lot. Like, we get a lot of rain like every day, and it kind of stagger them a bit, and the place is cold. But by treating them like this, in time they will change, I hope. I hope my next pepper patch will be better than this one. I'll get more experience on how to go about treating them for the rain, for too much rain. Because you know, rain is good, but you can get too much rain at times on the plants. Too much rain is not good for the plants. And there you have to treat them a lot to get them the way you want them, or to get them better results. I love my new sprayer so much. It is really comfortable. I recommend it to any farmer. It is super cool, super comfortable. The weight is okay on my back, not too much. I made a wonderful purchase. I should be out here earlier, but you know, that's how it goes sometimes. Because the sun is out already, kicking on my back. But that's a part of farming. Some days hot, some days cool. You have to adjust yourself with the temperature, with the weather, and go about and know that you have work to do, so you have to go and get your work done, regardless of the obstacles on the farm daily. This spray pan is super comfortable for a woman. I would recommend it for any farmer woman out there. These spray pans, like they are very comfortable. The strength is okay. The weight on your back is fine for a woman. It's not too much. It's a perfect spray for a woman right now. As I said before, my sweet peppers are not at their best, but I'm trying really hard with them, because the weather is really bad for them right now. And to top on that, the air is cold. It's very cold here. And sweet pepper needs heat alongside with water. Really adjustable. So it's farmer girl out here on her daily routine. Farming is life. Almost every day I'm out here doing stuff like this. Plant something today, reap something tomorrow. Such great feelings. Sweet pepper is not one of my favorite plants. I don't have much experience when it comes to sweet peppers, but I thought I transplant them after three to four weeks. So could say a month. I transplant them after a month. I saw them in the seedling trays, and I transplant them from there. But as I said, I don't have much experience with sweet peppers, but I'm doing my best, and this is my experience. It is I'm in a learning process now, and the experience is so good so far. So the next time around, I'm going to be much better. As you can see here, is I'm getting one there alongside the blossoms. So maybe by next week, I'm gonna have a lot of baby sweet peppers in here. As you see, I'm just treating them to see what outcome the best outcome I can get as possible. So about the next 2 to 2.5 weeks, I can be harvesting sweet peppers, like fully matured sweet peppers. To see more updates on what on my farm and how I go about my daily farm life, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel at Farmer Girl Jessie. Also, I have an Instagram page at Farmer Girl Jessie, so you can go over there, click like, subscribe for your daily timeline buster from my farm. And it's gonna be a lot of experience on my farm. There's a lot coming. So just please go over there, like, subscribe, and share. So it's about to rain, and I'm gonna have to spray fast enough before it rains so the treatment can dry on the plant and the leaves. Because if it doesn't dry, it doesn't do the plant no good. Then it's gonna wash it off if it comes right after spraying it. So I'm gonna wrap up my spraying really quick. I just can't stop complimenting this pan. Really can't stop complimenting this pan. This Gloria pan, the name is Gloria. So I guess I'm gonna call my spray pan Miss Gloria. This is a perfect spray pan. It's working wonders this morning. Finishing up on my pepper plants today. This is my last little quarter. Peeps, thanks for watching my video. I do appreciate it. Hit the subscribe button, like, and share my content, please, and thank you. So peeps, again, thanks for watching my content. Please hit the share button, subscribe, comment, and keep posted for more content coming, because trust me, don't miss out on the other one coming. It's going to be pure fun and enjoy.
I was the knight in shining armor in your movie. Would put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste now. I'm a ghost, I called your name, you look right through me. You're the reason I'm alone and masturbating. I've been trying to fix my pride, but that shit's broken. That shit's broken.